Behind Her Eyes is a six-part thriller, available to watch now on Netflix, which tells the story of a sinister love triangle with a shocking twist. If you've already watched it, and you're still in a state of disbelief, it's likely you're not alone. Think of this video as a way of confirming or denying everything you thought just happened. And if you haven't seen Behind Her Eyes yet, be warned. This will completely ruin a number of twists, so don't watch a second more if you're worried about spoilers.
You should go.
It's worth recapping exactly who everyone is, just so we're clear. As a reminder, Louise meets David, and they start an affair. Soon after that, she meets Adele, David's wife, and the two become friends. And as if that triangle isn't complicated enough, we also have Rob, Adele's friend whom she met at a psychiatric institution, potentially the most important character in the show. Let's break it all down. The relationship between Adele and Rob is critical. They both end up institutionalized because of their sleep issues. Rob's is linked to substance abuse, Adele's to the fire which tragically killed her parents. During their time together, Adele teaches Rob how to lucid dream.
Seriously, I would do anything that she told me.
We see all the tricks she uses to control her dreams, and Rob documents it all in his journal. Louise, who also suffers from night terrors, learns the same tricks when Adele gives her Rob's journal. The precise technique involves counting your fingers and stepping through an imaginary door, which allows Adele, Louise, and Rob to control what they dream about. It's a motif we see over and over in the series, and it all stems back to Adele's inherent abilities. But it's the next stage of the process that leads to that WTF ending. Stepping through a second door, while lucid dreaming allows you to astral project, an ability that means Rob, Adele, and Louise can leave their bodies and explore other areas. The only caveat is that you need to have previously visited an area so you can visualize it clearly.
Nice flat.
In the show, astral projection is represented by colored orbs, mainly so you can tell who's who. This is how Adele knows things she shouldn't. The assumption is she's been watching David and Louise all along.
Were you watching me this whole time? Everywhere I went?
No. It doesn't work like that. You can only travel to places you know.
It's implied Adele has been doing this for some time. Something she reveals to Rob while they're staying at her estate in Scotland.
I've always just called it traveling.
The two explore the local woods together, and afterwards, Rob becomes fascinated with the process and learns more about it, discovering it's possible to swap bodies with another person via astral projection. But this is all part of Rob's grand plan, providing the big twist in the series. He drugs his body before they astral project, so when Adele's spirit enters Rob's physical form, she can't move. Then Rob, inhabiting Adele's body, kills his own body and Adele with it, before throwing his own corpse down the well. David's watch goes in there as well, presumably as a way of keeping David quiet. This also explains why Adele is a heroin user, because that's Rob inside her body, and he's still addicted.
I have no idea who you are anymore.
David eventually suspects something is wrong with Adele, but he's a rationalist, refusing to countenance anything supernatural. We see this in the notes about Adele that Louise steals from his office. And he even says he doesn't know what happened to the girl he saved from the fire.
What happened to the girl?
I'm really not sure.
And as his relationship with Adele starts to deteriorate, Rob, inhabiting Adele's body, sees a fresh opportunity.
I want a divorce.
He befriends Louise, learns where she lives, and teaches her astral projection with the ultimate goal of swapping bodies with her and starting afresh. And that's exactly what happens. Louise receives a text from Adele saying she's going to commit suicide. Louise rushes to her rescue and astral projects, intending to save her. At the same time, Rob's spirit leaves Adele's body and inhabits Louise's body while she's projecting. Louise becomes trapped in Adele's body, which, just like before, Rob has injected with drugs. Rob, now in Louise's body, gives Louise a fatal overdose while she's in Adele's body, killing her and leaving the path free for him to start a new life with David.
And Adam.
Yeah.
And what about the fire? Well, the suspicion here is that David has something to do with it, but that's actually not the case. David really did save Adele, and the only reason it happened was because Adele was astral projecting at the time.
I was miles away, watching other people.
But that suspicion haunts David, and means that he never faces up to the body down the well, giving Rob, in Adele's body, the leverage he needs to control him. Especially when you remember his watch is down there.
You know you can never leave me, David.
So why does Rob do it? Because he's in love with David and envious of Adele's perfect life. He admits that he never wants to leave.
I'd stay forever if I could.
And by getting rid of Adele and eventually Louise, Rob gets to stay with David indefinitely. The last shot we see is of David and Louise, although strictly speaking, it's David and Rob, happily married and excited about their new life. The only problem might be Louise's son, Adam, but that's another story.
A Caribbean cruise.
But you hate boats. You've always said you hate boats.
Maybe I've changed.
So there you go. Did you see the twist coming? Did you ever suspect David? And did you manage to make it to the end of the series without anything being spoiled? Let us know in the comments and subscribe to Netflix UK for more features about your favourite movies and shows.